Christian Business Connection, connecting your business or ministry to the world.
Good morning and welcome to the CBC Radio Show. I'm your host, Evangelist Nona Thomas, saying that this is truly the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Well, let me tell you, friends, surely you are rejoicing on this Easter Sunday. Hallelujah. Why? Because he got up. Glory to God. I'm excited about this Easter Sunday. You know, I give God the glory, the honor, and the praise. He is great. He is great. And I don't know if you were at a sunrise service this morning, or if you're coming from your regular morning service, or on your way to your 10, 11 o'clock service, I want to say thank you for listening to the CBC Radio Show. I want to say that I give God the glory for this program. Yes, I do. And for all of the guests who are on our show today and who have been on the CBC Radio Show. Oh yeah, today is a shouting day. Every day is a shouting day. Why? Because if you're listening to the sound of my voice, then that tells me that you're breathing. That tells me that you're alive. That tells me that you should be saying thank you to a God who is merciful, who is kind, who is generous, who is great and greatly to be praised. Well, I want to just say this morning a special happy Easter and good morning to Eddie Randall and Sons Funeral Home. Mr. Randall, thank you so much for being one of the sponsors of the CBC Radio Show. God bless you and your staff and family and the wonderful work that you are doing. I also want to say thank you so much to the Urban League of Metropolitan St. Louis for being one of my sponsors. Thank you so much. You know, God is so good. He is blessing the Christian Business Connection. I encourage all of you to go to my website, thecbcradioshow.com, so you can see all of the listings of the sponsors for this program and this organization. God is good. To God be the glory. One more time. I can say that over and over again. When I tell you, friends, we have a great power-packed program on this Easter Sunday, I mean it. We really do. I want to say the first guest on my program this morning is going to be my pastor, Pastor R.B. Peterson of Memorial Tabernacle Christian Life Center. And I love this piece that he's going to talk about because actually this is a rerun of the program that he did on my Wednesday at 4 p.m. show, which is the midweek message with Evangelist Nona Thomas. Pastor Peterson was the guest host, and it was such a wonderful, wonderful time that he shared and scripture on that program that I'm rerunning it for you. It is apropos on this Easter Sunday as well. And then after Pastor Peterson, we're going to be talking this morning with Reverend Alonzo Griffin, the marketing director of O. Henry Restaurant, and the executive chef, Mr. Chuck Fox. They're going to talk about that wonderful spread of delicious food that they have for the entire city of St. Louis on this Easter Sunday. Great interview. You want to make sure you hear what they're featuring today. And also, we've had such a great demand for this segment. I want to rerun on the program Mrs. Angelia Bills and Mr. Jamie Dennis of the Urban League Metropolitan St. Louis talking about the Save Our Sons program. Let me tell you, friends, this program is so pivotal in the St. Louis metropolitan area, and it is truly, truly worth making sure that everyone gets an opportunity to hear this broadcast. So we're going to talk with them this morning. It is going to be a blessing to you. All right, friends, look, when we come back, we're going to start off the Word of God right here with my pastor, Pastor R.B. Peterson, and so much more. Might even have some surprises and things in there for you. You never know. You got to listen to the whole program to find out about it. You know, I do want to say, friends, that make sure you don't miss one single episode of the CBC Radio Show in April, because we will be featuring our author of the month, which will be none other than Dr. Gloria Johnson. Her heartwarming, inspiring book, I Cried Alone. Let me tell you, you have got to get your copy. You have got to listen to what this woman of God is going to be talking about. It's about domestic violence. And I believe that at some point in our lives, we know someone may have personally been involved with some type of domestic violence. But let me tell you, you're going to be inspired and you're going to be encouraged as we feature her book, I Cried Alone, during the month of April. All right, friends, we're going to take a short break right here. Coming back, my pastor, Reverend R.B. Peterson.
The Christian Business Connection is proud to announce that in April, we will be featuring our Author of the Month series, featuring Dr. Gloria Johnson's heartwarming and inspiring book, I Cry Alone. Listen weekly in April as Dr. Johnson talks about this amazing book. Get more info and to get your copy, go to thecbcradioshow.com.
Hi, this is Michael McMillan, President and CEO of the Urban League of Metropolitan St. Louis. Glad to be here with evangelist Nona Thomas on the Christian Business Connection radio show.
Welcome back, friends, to the CBC Radio Show. On this Easter Sunday morning, here's a special message from my pastor, Reverend R.B. Peterson.
We start thinking about all of the benefits that have been given to us through the shed blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. I just want to point you back for a few moments to a passage of Scripture that really has nothing to do with Easter per se, but there's a principle in the Word of God that I want you to think about this week. And so the Scripture is 2 Corinthians chapter 8, verse 9, and it says, "For you know the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though he was rich, yet for your sakes he became poor, that you through his poverty might become rich." I want you to think about that for a few minutes. We know that John calls Jesus the Word of God, always in heaven with the Father. He is the expressed image of the Father, and he was born into this world. Before Jesus took on flesh, think about the glories of heaven, the splendor of who he is as God. Everything that he had before him, all of the universe, all of the angels, everything surrounding him, the radiance. You can go into the book of Revelation and you can read about the splendor of heaven and the glories of everyone that's there. And God thought more of us. He looked at our broken condition, at our broken lives, and saw in us himself. Remember in John chapter 1, the Bible says that this light is the light that lights every man who comes into the world. When God looked on us in our broken, sinful condition, he saw still his love that he placed in us. He still saw his knowledge that he placed in all of the universe. And he valued us. That's a really popular song that's being played on the air now, and it says that he thought enough to save us. And it's a beautiful song because it really tells the truth that God's mind and his thoughts, his love, has always been on us. The Bible tells us that when we were dead in trespasses and sin, God sent forth his Son to die for us. Romans chapter 5 tells us that when we were without strength, Christ died for the ungodly. So it wasn't when we got everything together, when we started being our best, when we started coming into the fellowship of believers. No, it wasn't that time. It was when we were at our very worst, when there was no help for us, when we were in the condition that the Bible says we were without hope in the world, that Christ died for us. And so as we look at what's going to happen this weekend and we remember Calvary and we think about all that transpired out on that cross, how Isaiah prophesied about it in Isaiah 53, saying he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement that brought us peace was upon him, and it's by his stripes that we're healed. We remember all of what has transpired in our few days that we've been alive, and how much grace, how much love, how much generosity God has given us through the blood of the Lord Jesus to atone for our sin. And we can remember that all of those riches belong to him, but he chose to give them to us. We were poor. We had no help. We had nothing. But Christ, in his riches, thought it not robbery to be equal with God, it tells us in Philippians chapter 2. But he took on no reputation and took on the form of a servant. And being formed and fashioned as a servant, he humbled himself and was obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. And the Bible continues to say there that God also has highly exalted him and given him the name that is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee bows, every tongue confesses, those in heaven, those in earth, and those beneath the earth, they bow their knees to the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, confessing that Jesus Christ is Lord of all, to the glory of God the Father. See, the Lord Jesus gave up everything so that he could have you and so that he could have me. He gave up everything for us. And so as we look at this season, at what we're celebrating, we know that about the Easter Bunny and spring and new life, and those are nice things to consider, and they are truths. But the essence of what we celebrate is Calvary. It's the cross. It's the place where God gave up everything to redeem us, to buy us back to himself. And as we look at this passage further, it says that though he was rich, yet for your sakes he became poor. He gave up everything. Isaiah calls him the suffering servant, a man acquainted with sorrow, one who was acquainted with grief. To give up all of the angels bowing in your presence, to come down into a filthy little world, to be born of a virgin and placed in a feeding trough outside of town. The highest and the most high is what we call him, became the most low so that he could reach every sinner. There's no one today who's so far away from the love and power of God that he can be redeemed. That's what I love about him, that it was through his poverty that I became rich, through Christ giving up all of his splendor, giving up all of his. He even brought himself down so that he could work in a physical body. If you can imagine how the God of the universe scaled his power down so that he could still live in a body and live as a man and be affected with the things that we're affected of. The Bible tells us that he was tempted in all points just as we are, yet without sin. That he even brought himself down and even allowed the angel that he made, who was Lucifer, who became Satan, to even tempt him so that we can look at how he overcame and know that we can overcome as well. For us, he became impoverished. You know, I always think about the pictures of Christ and how the halo is always around him to show the radiance of his glory. But then I think about the fact that the Lord Jesus, as he walked physically in the earth, he didn't have a halo on him. There was nothing special about him in the way that he looked. But whenever he got on the scene, the love of God in him caused people, circumstances, and situations to change. The love in Christ caused everything to start revealing the glory of God in the lives of the people that he touched. So, for our sakes, he became poor, that we, through his poverty, might be made rich. And I need you to understand that the riches that come from Christ aren't financial riches. You'll get those things as you live for Christ and as you live in the principles of the scripture. If you make it your business to sow, then you know you're going to reap whatever it is you sow, whether it's time, love, money. But in Christ, we've reaped something that we couldn't sow. We've reaped righteousness. We are now the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. And I don't know about you, but I can think back to earlier in the day when something got under my skin and I wasn't acting like Christ acts. But at the same time, him knowing me, him allowing me to enter into his presence and ask for forgiveness and ask for strength to repent and turn, he's there still making me rich, enriching my life with his strength, enriching my life with forgiveness. If you've never did as the old song says, count your blessings one by one, you should take this Easter season to count your blessings, to see how rich you really are because of Christ Jesus. There's nothing in this universe that can compare to what he's bought for you through his blood. You know, love costs. I say this a lot when I preach. You know you really love somebody when it costs you. It costs your energy. It costs your strength. It costs your time. Sometimes it costs money. Whatever it is, when it comes down to true love always has a value. Why? Because of whatever, whomever it is that person loves, that value is why you give. It's why you do. So God looked in us and saw something of value. He saw us not as we were and as we are, but he saw us redeemed with himself forever and ever. He saw the glory of himself that would be in us once we became his children. And for that, he endured the cross. For that, he put his son through the suffering and through the shame so that we could be redeemed. I don't know about anybody else, but I thank God for Jesus. I thank God for the sacrifice that he made in giving his son for us so that we could have eternal life. You know, I'm not waiting to inherit the riches that Christ died for. Those are mine. Now, if you need to know what those riches are, there's a power of God that continues to draw you and deliver you out of sin. Another one of those riches is the peace of God that surpasses everything that we understand. It keeps, it guards our heart and mind. It means that when there's trouble and there's anxieties and the world is spinning out of control, the Spirit of God in us gives us perfect peace. He keeps our hearts settled in the fact that he's in control of everything. Another one of the treasures from heaven is the authority. Jesus said, "Behold, I give you authority to tread on the serpents and scorpions over all of the power of the enemy, and by no means shall he hurt you." Those riches are for you. As you go into Easter this year, I want you to not ever, ever, ever forget that you have become the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus, that the riches that he bought for you at Calvary belong to you, and you have the authority, the power, the agape of God to demonstrate this for all the world to see. As I get ready to close, I'm going to have a brief moment of prayer with you. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray now for this listener, for this viewer, asking you to enrich them now this year. God, let this Easter be a new life for them, a new day for them. God, I ask you to deliver them out of sin, to deliver them out of poverty. God, to bring them into the fullness of your kingdom. God, let your kingdom come in their life and let it manifest all the brilliance and the glory of who you are. We bind the works of darkness. We bind Satan's powers over them now in the name of the Lord Jesus. God, give them grace and give them strength. I'll give you praise and I'll give you thanks, Lord Father, in Jesus' name. Amen. I love you. Morning worship at 10. Our address is 1350 South Lafayette, Florissant, Missouri. You can find us at themtclc.org, or you can follow us on Facebook. If you want our phone number, it's 921-6825. But you belong with us, and you belong in Christ Jesus this Easter season. Lord bless you. Have a wonderful and a blessed Easter.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Vance Watt. I'm the worship arts pastor at the Word at Shaw Church here in St. Louis, Missouri, where we serve the community in word and in deed. I'm so excited to be here this morning on the CBC radio show with evangelist Nona Thomas. I'd like to extend a warm welcome to you and your family to come worship with us at the Word at Shaw at 11 a.m. on Sunday morning. We're located at 4265 Shaw Boulevard, St. Louis, Missouri, 63110. Or you can visit our website at www.thewordatshaw.org. God bless.
Hi, this is Evangelist Nona Thomas, inviting you to tune in to Hallelujah 1600 at 4 p.m. every Wednesday for the midweek message. Friends, let me tell you, this program will encourage you. It will inspire you. It will be the boost that will be right on time in the Word of God for your Wednesday afternoon. So tune in every Wednesday, 4 p.m., right here on Hallelujah 1600 for the midweek message with Evangelist Nona Thomas. To God be the glory.
Greetings, St. Louis. This is Jamie Dennis, director of the Save Our Sons program from the Urban League of Metropolitan St. Louis. If you want to be a blessing to your father, your brother, or son, or any male that you just care about, please send them our way. You can reach me at 314-388-9840. We're preparing generations for the workforce and jobs, employment, soft skills, financial literacy, leadership development, and career training. For more information, you can look up our program on www.ulstl.com.
Welcome back to the CBC Radio Show. I'm your host, Evangelist Nona Thomas, and on this Easter Sunday, I know that many of us are thinking about what are we going to eat, where are we going to go. We don't feel like cooking. Well, let me tell you, I'm going to tell you to go to Old Henry's Restaurant, located right there at 8600 Airport Road. We're so blessed this morning that we have the marketing director of Old Henry's Restaurant and the executive chef of Old Henry right here on the CBC Radio Show. So I want to say a special good morning to Reverend Alonzo Griffin and Mr. Chuck Fox. Good morning, gentlemen.
Good morning.
Now, who gonna ask him a question? You know I say it all the time, y'all know. And that is this the day that the Lord has made for you?
Yes, it is. We will rejoice and be glad in it.
That's right. Is he speaking for you too, Mr. Chuck?
Amen.
Amen. Well, happy Easter to you, gentlemen.
Same to you.
You know, on this beautiful day, it's a beautiful day, regardless of the weather or any of that. It's a beautiful day because this is when we celebrate what our Lord and Savior did for us. And I know your gifts are to celebrate in the way of food there at Old Henry. So you got to tell us what's going on Easter Sunday at Old Henry.
Yes. So Old Henry's going to do this normal, a nice Sunday lunch, brunch. We're going to add some ham on that buffet with some pineapples, and hopefully we can get people to come through. And we still have your greens, your sweet potatoes, your cabbage, and your green beans. Everything's going to be good.
You say everything?
Everything.
Everything.
Everything is good.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is. And I know also, now, are you going to have a little barbecue on that menu today as well?
We also going to have some barbecue. We have barbecue every day at Old Henry. Those of you who all that don't feel like cooking this Easter, you just come on down to Old Henry. We'll take care of your needs.
I know you will. Reverend Griffin, you know, that smokehouse menu and what you all feature there is really unique in the St. Louis area, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am. We beef brisket is to die for. And so if you want a beef brisket sandwich, come by and get one of those. We had some on the buffet this past week, and it sold real well. And we expect people to come out and get some more of that, plus our baby back ribs, our smoked chicken. It is so much on our menu that it's kind of hard to explain it all at one time, you know?
I do. Now, for those of us who, you know, we hear the term smokehouse, but there's actually some special equipment, some special ovens, some special things you all did to ensure that it is the best of the best. Can you tell us about that?
Yeah, we installed $100,000 worth of equipment so we can get the best product possible. So our owner doesn't have step when it comes to equipment and to satisfaction and the quality.
And that's so important. You know, Chef Chuck, when we talk about quality, you know, it's not only just in the presentation. And let me say that the presentation of the food at Old Henry's is spectacular. But it's got to go right along with that old-fashioned taste, doesn't it?
Oh, but of course. We're not leaning away from the perfection. The smoke in the meat is perfection. Mm-hmm. Two types of wood for flavor. It's about the best barbecue in town.
What you say, in town? All right, that's a big boast. So they got to come by and check it out for real, don't they?
Yeah, we can get some of them out there, a little competition. Just come on, try Old Henry's out. Give us a chance. Experience the menu. We have some regulars. They love us.
Yes, they do. They do. You know, Reverend Griffin, of course, I've eaten there so many times, I can't even count. But one thing that impresses me, in addition to your Sunday spread, that's always so wonderful, and we know it is today on Easter too, but through the week, you all have a fabulous special every single day. Now, which one of you guys is going to tell us about that?
Well, I can tell you about the specials. Mondays are back to work Mondays. I'm sorry. It's the day where you come, where you get ready back to work. You may not want to go to work, but we can feed you to make you be patient at work and let the time go by even a little faster. We got our Tasty Tuesdays. We have a Way Back Wednesdays, which we offer a senior discount on that day. So if you come in, if you're over 55, we will give you a 10% discount on your meal for that day. That's Way Back Wednesdays. We have Italian Thursdays and Seafood Fridays and Smokehouse Saturdays.
Now, that also flows right in to our Sundays. Now, if I have folks who have just tuned in, I'm talking this morning with Chef Chuck Fox and Reverend Alonzo Griffin of Old Henry's Restaurant. On this Easter, I want you all to go through detail one more time on what's on that menu today.
Yes, ma'am. We have, we're going to have ham. We have smoked meat products.
Chicken.
Baked chicken, smothered chops, fried chicken.
Meatloaf.
Meatloaf, dressing.
Mac and cheese.
Mac greens. And cheese, famous mac and cheese. They lady ate a mac and cheese.
Yeah.
Greens, green beans, cabbage, nice corn muffin to go with your meal. Also, just come on down to Old Henry.
Also got a homemade potato salad. We also got homemade coleslaw and a great pasta salad. A cranberry, a cran raisin. What you call that, Chuck?
Penne with cran raisins pasta salad.
Yeah.
Oh,
pretty
my.
Good.
And so that's what people are really getting into that right now. We can't stop making it because people ask for it all the time.
Yeah,
That's like a new item almost that we're trying out here at Old Henry's. And we have some of the best desserts in town.
You know, you took it out of my mouth, Reverend Griffin. I was going to say, we can never stop talking enough about the desserts. The desserts are fantastic.
Right. Sweet potato pie is second to none.
That is excellent. Now, let's say that we've got folks coming in today and, you know, they may want to take, you know, a meal home with them. They want to take those ribs with them. Can they do that? Can they take a big serving with them or get something catered today?
They can't get anything catered on a Sunday, but we do have to-go boxes and containers that you can take your thing home and enjoy it at your own place.
That's right.
After you get your soul fed at the church, come get your body fed at Old Henry.
Indeed. Now tell us where you are located.
We're at 8600 Airport Road, the corner of Hanley and Airport Road, just a little east of 170.
That's right. And what's the phone number?
The phone number is 314-736-6800.
One more time.
That's 314-736-6800.
Now, on this Easter Sunday, what is the hours of your operation today?
It's 10 to 6.
10 to 6. Okay, so they got plenty of time to go on over to Old Henry's.
They got plenty of time. Like I said, after you get your soul fed, come get your body fed at Old Henry's. We'll be glad to have you.
That's right. You know, we would be remiss if we did not talk about the delicious breakfast and the different options that you can have for a true buffet. Tell us about that breakfast menu, would you, Chef Fox?
We have a breakfast menu. It's like a speedy buffet. We do omelets. We do food to order. But we do have an express buffet with food laid out on there. You got scrambled eggs, eggs with cheese. You got shrimp. You got grits with cheese, bacon sausage, turkey sausage, hash, home fries. And just come on down and try our breakfast. It's a little different. But for those who's on their way to work, you can pick it out real quick and be right out the door.
That's it. And I have also got to compliment you guys. You have some of the best chicken wings in St. Louis. And that goes wonderful with that chicken wings and waffles for breakfast, doesn't it?
Chicken and waffles, shrimp and grits, all day.
All day. I love it. I absolutely love it. You know, Chef, with your many years of experience that you have in doing what you do, you know, you specialize in food for the soul. And so, you know, just tell us about that and how, you know, your passion truly has kept you doing what you're doing now for so many years.
Well, you said it, food for the soul. There's no other way to please someone you don't know but by through food. Everyone loves food. So you make that food for the soul right, you have friends indeed.
Yes, you do. And you got a lot of friends in the St. Louis metropolitan area. Reverend Griffin, can I say the same thing for you? Because you are also passionate about O. Henry's. What keeps you going?
smiles on people's faces. It's the pretty smiles we get. It's the reaction we get from the customers when they try our food for the first time. We just glow when we see you and you're surprised, because sometimes it may take a... Everything to me is a memory, you know, and so sometimes a food can bring back a good memory. And so when I see a person smile and I say, they look at the person they're eating with, and they'll say, wow, this tastes like my mom's or this tastes like my aunt. And that's what we want here at Old Henry's. We want that family feel. And we want you to feel like you're at home. You can do everything but take your shoes off here, all right? So
don't do that.
Don't do that still, yes, sir. But we want you to feel at home. And if you want to stay 2 hours, you can. If you want to stay 20 minutes, you can. If you just want to pick up and go, you can. But you're going to get the same atmosphere that you would get at home. So we want the love to go outside our doorways and to brighten our community, because sometimes we need a brightness in our community.
That is so true. And I do have to say that I believe everyone feels that welcome. They feel that hospitality when you come into Old Henry. Never, ever are you not greeted with a hello, with a smile. The service is excellent. Your wait staff is excellent. It's just, I mean, Old Henry is the place to go. Well, I tell you, gentlemen, we're just about out of time. Is there anything else that you'd like to say in closing on this Easter Sunday, Chef?
I would love to see everyone in here on Easter Sunday. You did feel like cooking. The church too full to eat. Just come on over to Old Henry. We can take care of your needs.
That's right. And Reverend Griffin.
On this Resurrection Sunday, I hope everybody have a blessed and safe event. This is the day that we know we are saved by grace. And so I just want everybody to know that God still loves you. God is still for you. And we at Old Henry is here to serve you. So God bless you.
I love it. I love it. Thank you, gentlemen, for being a part of the CBC radio show. Thank you, Lady Ada Taylor, for the vision that the Lord gave her and that she just walked out on faith and did. Thank you all so much.
Thank you, sister. Bless you.
All right, friends, we're going to take a short break. Stay with me. I'll be right back.
Hello, this is Reggie Reyes, the Bishop of Comedy, on your CBC Comedy Nuggets for today. And it's enduring. I know sometimes them kids can really get on your nerves, and it's getting close to summertime. So what I'm saying, we got to endure what they're going to put us through. They ain't going to be out of school for 2 months longer, but I'm just saying, endure. Just think about the Bishop of Comedy. Endure. I know you want to whoop them. I do too. But endure it. God bless you. Love you to life.
The Christian Business Connection is proud to announce that in April, we will be featuring our Author of the Month series, featuring Dr. Gloria Johnson's heartwarming and inspiring book, I Cried Alone. Listen weekly in April as Dr. Johnson talks about this amazing book. Get more info and to get your copy, go to thecbcradioshow.com.
Hi, I'm Angelia Bills, Vice President of Communications for the Urban League of Metropolitan St. Louis, and I'm glad to be here with Evangelist Nona Thomas on the Christian Business Connection radio show.
Welcome back to the CBC radio show. I'm your host, Evangelist Nona Thomas, and friends, I told you at the top of the program I was so excited about what God is doing right here in the St. Louis metropolitan area. I tell you, we're so blessed this morning because we have on the program Mr. Jamie Dennis, who is the director of the Urban League Save Our Sons program. I can't wait till we get into this interview. You're truly going to be blessed. And we also have in the studio with us this morning, Mrs. Angelia Bills, who is the Vice President of Communications for the Urban League. So welcome, everybody.
Thank you.
Now, I didn't prep you on this question. So, Angelia, I'm going to put the question to you, okay? And you can chime in, all right? And that is this the day that the Lord has made for you?
Absolutely.
Absolutely. We on one accord.
Right. The reason for the season.
Okay. So we can go forward now. Yeah. Very good. I ask everybody that question when they come on the show. Mr. Dennis, you know, ma'am. I tell you, this program, Save Our Sons, which really is across the country.
Right.
We've just got to get to the core of the matter because I love just the title. The title speaks so poignantly about what you're doing. So tell us about Save Our Sons.
Well, Save Our Sons, as you know, is a universal distress signal That means that we're in a bad situation, we're in dire straits, and we need help. So I feel like it's almost prophetic, this program, because it came out of the ashes like a rising phoenix from the Ferguson unrest.
Yes.
And had it not been for the sacrifice of Michael Brown, bless his soul, I wouldn't be sitting in this studio doing this interview trying to affect some positive change in that area.
Indeed. It made not only a difference here in our metropolitan area, but really across the world, didn't
it? The world.
The entire world.
Yes,
so tell us how Save Our Sons, what it's doing. What is the objective of the program?
Okay, well, the objective of Save Our Sons is soft skills training re-educating men to get back into the workforce.
Mm-hmm.
We take them through the four pillars of employment, which is how to get a job, how to keep a job, how to get promoted,
mm-hmm.
and lastly, which I feel is most important, how to remain marketable.
Now, that's very good. That's very good. And Mrs. Bills, I think what's important there is the last part. I love that last part, how to remain marketable, because so many things come upon us in life. And, you know, and so how do you keep going? So it's important, isn't it?
It is very important, because not only do you have to find the job, but you have to keep the job.
Mm-hmm.
And then, of course, we all want to be promoted.
Right.
That's
right.
Right.
Right. Right. As the Vice President of Communications, I mean, I know you're talking about Save Our Sons everywhere you go. And what has been the response that you've gotten from the community?
We have gotten an awesome response.
Love.
Because the success rate is so high.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and word of mouth is traveling.
Yes.
That, I mean, we're near 100% in
yes.
placement of jobs.
That's right.
So Jamie and his staff has done a magnificent job.
Yes.
What you say, near 100%?
99%.
That means that you all are really boots on the ground, aren't
yes,
you?
Yes, ma'am, we are. We are. We're going to where the people are in that community, and not just waiting for them to come through the doors. We actually go out and we knock at doors. We visit the local mom and pop stores, let them know what are we out and what are we after. And, you know, sometimes I feel like that's one of the most effective ways to get them. You know, we have promotions and we have commercials in the radio, but I think it's more effective when you're stomping the pavement and in someone's face like, look, I have an opportunity that I don't think you want to pass up.
Indeed. I'm so glad you said that, because what that really shows folks is you actually care.
Yes, ma'am.
You know, because we can talk a whole lot and we can administrate, but to actually be there in your face at the
yes.
door saying, look, there's an opportunity
right.
here for you. Take advantage of it.
Right.
That's absolutely great.
Yes, ma'am. And for that demographic that we serve, I think they need that extra auxiliary support
mm-hmm.
of someone giving them a little nudge. Because,
yes.
you know, typically when people come in on their own accord, I think they have success. But
yes.
usually a lot of times you'll see someone maybe through the ages of 17 to maybe 25, and you have a grandmother or you have a father or just a girlfriend begging and pleading with us, could you please find my man or my son
yes.
a job? And I always tell them, okay, well, where's that candidate?
Mm-hmm.
Where's the participant? Because
mm-hmm.
I need to see him, and I need to see if he's actually ready to work.
Yes.
Because, you know, the quest is really to seek that self-determination.
Yes.
And we try to bring that out of them and give them a support system to do that.
Indeed. And as you say, support system. So how did the community rally around this so that, you know, you have entities, you have businesses, you have corporations that say, we want to be a part of what's going with Save Our Sons?
Well, it was almost immediate, because
mm-hmm.
literally we started Save Our Sons in November of 2014
mm-hmm. right.
was when it was birthed out of
that's
the
right.
literal riots that were going on.
Oh, right. yeah, yeah.
Mr. Right. McMillan was like,
he was out there.
He was out there. He was
mm-hmm.
on the streets. He was talking to the protesters. And basically he asked them the question,
mm-hmm.
what do you all want?
Mm-hmm.
Because Martin Luther King said that rioting is the language of the unheard.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
And so he took Martin Luther King's advice in that
mm-hmm.
sense and asked,
mm-hmm.
what is it that you all need?
Mm-hmm.
And the sounding answer was jobs.
Mm.
Yep.
And then we looked at the statistics, and African-American men are three times as likely to be unemployed than anybody else.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's how Save Our Sons was born.
Mm-hmm.
And the corporate community, the civic community, everybody latched on to the idea.
They really
started,
did.
Started January
mm-hmm.
2015
that's right.
with
that's
a
right.
huge support base.
Wow.
And it's just been rolling ever since, and we're just
yes.
thankful for it.
And you know, that's really, it's so God, because so many things can shut down,
right.
not get started during
right.
that turbulent time. You
yes.
know what I'm saying?
Yes.
And so through the cries of the community and
mm-hmm.
through everything that was going on, Save Our Sons was birthed.
That's right.
And so what has it done for you personally, Mr. Dennis, being
well,
a part and seeing this thing grow?
Well, it's really, I'm elated to even get to give my testimony about what it's done for me, because mm-hmm. I not only get to save other young men, but I was saved by this program. Mm. It gives you opportunity. I've actually put some of my own sons through this program. I know it works. You know, it's not anything magical that we're doing. We're not reinventing the wheel. We're just teaching people, you know, that's coming from an impoverished community what they need to do, what benchmarks need to be met. And then if they can make it out of this program, most of the times we see that they do very well once they get a job assignment.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah. Well, I want to let my listeners know, if you're just tuning in this morning, we're talking with Mr. Jamie Dennis, the director of the Urban League Save Our Sons program, and Mrs. Angelia Bills, the vice president of communications for Urban League. Now, I know my listeners are listening right now, and they're like, how do I get my grandson? How do I get my husband? How do I get my brother, my uncle? Okay. So get right to how can folks do that?
Well, first of all, I always will advise you to research. Go to www.ulstl.com. Read up on Save Our Sons. And if you're on the fast track, you could call myself, Mr. Dennis, or Mr. Cardwell. My number is 314-388-9840. Mr. Cardwell over at the North Oaks location is 679-3500. Just the SOS hotline, and we're always on standby. We do two classes. One goes from 9:30 to 12:30, and if you can't make the early class, we have afternoon class, which starts from 1:30 to 4:30, which is located in Jennings.
So, Mr. Dennis, one of the ways to get started is they contact you, and they have to go through a series of training. Is that correct?
Yes, that's correct. They come in with two forms of ID, a valid state ID, driver's license, social security card. We fill out an intake application. We talk to them and counsel them and kind of see what are their ambitions and where they want to be. You know, because a lot of times people, they come into the doors and they're like, what kind of jobs do you have? And then I'm asking them, like, well, what type of jobs have you done? And what's your passion? What are you passionate about? Mm-hmm. Because we really try to fine-tune, mm-hmm. you know, our workforce. And we're actually doing a favor for the HR, because we're actually seeing what type of people we're sending out. And the HRs are really starting to get it. They're starting to come in. I mean, we have big partners that come in. Some people from Home Depot, Starbucks. They always come to the program. They've been involved with us for like 9 months of the program. And they love the men. You know, they always are lending expertise and advice. We teach them the power of networking, where you get a friendship and a relationship, right. You know, then you build upon that. So a lot of times you may see a guy that comes in with two master degrees. He has a lot of education, but he doesn't know how to sell himself. Mm-hmm. So the week of how to remain marketable will really speak to him. Mm-hmm. And you may have a guy that's never worked a job a day in his life. Maybe he was in the penitentiary 15, 20 years, never even knew that applications were now being done on the internet. And we can get him entry-level position to where he can have some kind of pride. And, you know, you should really see these guys' face when they get their certificates at the end of this class.
Yes, yes.
One kid, a 20-year-old, he got his SOS certificate of completion, and he said in tears, this is better than my high school diploma.
Wow.
So that really speaks volumes.
It does. It does. And also what speaks volumes is you're getting ready to approach the graduating class. Am I right?
Right. That's right. Mm-hmm. It's going to be down at the Urban League headquarters at the Vaughn Cultural Center on February the 17th at 6:30. We're going to be graduating this class number 7. And for those that are still interested and want to involve themselves with the SOS, we're starting another class March the 7th. And we're always open to volunteers. We're always open to participants. We can never see enough people coming through those doors. We just need each one to tell one to bring another friend, because that's what we preach to the people that come through the program. Well, you're going to be our best promotion, because you have a job. You're doing well. You're no longer behind on your child support. You're being a tax-paying, productive citizen. And we want them to be role models, because that's what it's about at the end of the day. You know, training someone, and like the ad says, training the child away should go.
Yes.
And when he grows old, he won't depart.
He won't depart so from it. You know, just to be a part of what this is here in the metropolitan area, but I understand there are other locations across the country. Is that right, Mrs. Bills?
That is correct. Save Our Sons is a national Urban League program that existed previously, where it focused more on health and wellness throughout the country. But what is happening now, since our model has been instituted. National Urban League is working to put it in other cities.
Yes.
Specifically Baltimore and the cities that have had the
unrest. Ooh, perfect, perfect, yes. Perfect. And, you know, it's something because as we were talking about, you know, the word of God in that, you know, the evil that you meant to do against me, right. God turned it around for our good.
A weapon formed.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. And so what I love about it, okay, Save Our Sons, SOS. I mean, come on now. Who that's, it's brilliant. It's just brilliant. It had to have come from God.
Yeah, I believe so. and it's clear that a lot of people we see since we've made this program, you see a lot of SOS satellites popping up around the region.
Really?
And yes, we just want to extend our camaraderie. We want to say it takes a total community to correct this age-long problem. So we don't have any egos, any hidden agendas. We just really want to supplement the workforce and get that terrible, terrible ratio of us being three times as not to be employed. We want to get that out of here.
Definitely, definitely. Yeah. Now, I know that we also have an event. We have a networking event coming up March 11th, and you're going to hear more about that throughout the month. But that's also going to be an opportunity for people to come out and sign up for the SOS program. Am I right?
Yes, ma'am.
It's an opportunity to come sign up for Save Our Sons. Mm-hmm. Also, if you want to just help the Urban League.
Come
on.
You know, yes.
Volunteering, and, you know, it's so important to our mission.
Isn't it?
We serve 92,000 people every
year. Yes,
and we
do.
Only have a staff of 200.
That's right.
So we are very.
It's our lifeblood.
Yes, yes, yes.
You know, because our mission is helping African Americans and others.
Yes.
And something I wanted to say about the Save Our Sons program, which I think is key to its success, is that we have hired strong African American male role models to teach the program.
Mm-hmm.
And I think by the participants coming in and seeing somebody who looks like them. Mm-hmm. Who are successful, it motivates them to be successful also.
Oh, that's indeed, right. Indeed. I know you see that. That's repeated over and over,
yes,
isn't
ma'am.
It, Mr. Dennis?
It really is. We teach them to dress for success. And you should really see a guy that comes in off the streets that's not used to that.
Yeah.
He's taken aback a little bit, maybe the first week. But after that first week of training, he really starts to gravitate towards and he gets it. He puts on a suit because we make suits available due to kind, generous sponsors that donates business
wow,
suits.
Wow, yes.
So we don't give him any reason to fail.
Right.
Know? If a guy's like, oh, well, I don't have anything to wear, okay, step to the SOS closet.
Right.
And get you an outfit so
step
you can
step to
go
the closet,
interview.
Right.
That's right. That's right.
it's really a winner all the way around,
thank
isn't
you.
It? It's just simply a winner. And so volunteers are needed.
Yes,
for
the
Save Our Sons program.
Yes, any volunteers. We need HR reps. We need hiring managers. We need people that really want to be a part of this change and bring economic resources to bear and to actually give our guys a chance, you know, because a lot of the people coming, we have people like from Valvoline, people from Centene, people from Ameren that have actually came in and volunteered their services, and they actually make friendships and the guys find mentors. So we really are bridging the gap as the Urban League's mission is to bring economic viability to an underserved community.
Yes. Now, let me ask you, are you also looking for corporations,
yes.
more businesses to hire to be
yes.
a part of this program? Tell us how they can do that, Mrs. Beals.
Yes, very much so. And really, they can contact our they can contact Jamie Dennis at 388-9840.
That's right.
If they're interested in helping our guys find jobs. One of the most exciting things I wanted to share with you from our groundbreaking is that we had a young man who was there giving his testimony about how he wasn't able to find a job anywhere. He was just cutting grass or whatever, you know, odd jobs people would give him.
Right.
But after going through the Save Our Sons program, he literally got 5 job offers.
Oh.
Yes. And piggyback off of that story.
An overflow.
And the piggyback off of that story, he had actually went, he's hired now at Dobbs. He's moving up in the ranks. And he interviewed at Dobbs at first and was rejected. After going through the program, he tried it again and he got it.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. So now I'm glad you mentioned that. So do the folks who graduate, or, you know, do they come back? Do you allow them to come back and give their testimony and be of encouragement?
Yes.
Because, you know, each step of the journey, you know, sometimes can be challenging,
that's
but to
right.
see that somebody actually made it.
Man, those are our greatest sounding board is the guys that come through the program and they come back and they tell their testimony to the guys. You should just see their faces.
Mm-hmm.
It makes a person that that maybe potentially could drop out of the program, once he hears a testimony like that, mm-hmm. he realizes that it's real. And yes. It's tangible.
Yes. Mm-hmm. You know, we're just about out of time, but Mrs. Bills, in closing, is there anything else that you'd like to say about the importance of the Save Our Sons program?
I would just like to say that the Save Our Sons program is a community effort. Mm-hmm. It's a group effort, and it takes a nation mm-hmm. to help young African-American men.
That's right.
We have been in a state of emergency mm-hmm. in the black community for far too long.
Yes.
And I'm
yes.
just grateful that now we have a program, a vehicle
yes.
that can help our young African-American men find jobs and yes. be sustainable for their families and their community.
That's right. And if I can,
please,
a message for the community. Please inspire these young black males. Push them. Don't let them give up any hope. Don't let them make excuses for failure. And tell them to come on and sign up. That's what we really want. We would like to help you. We would like to, you know, do God's work and empower you. So come on down and yes. sign up.
Yes. Give us all of the contact information yes. one more time, would you?
My office number is 314-388-9840. Mr. Caldwell at the North Oaks Center is 314-679-3500. You can visit www.ulstl.com. Save Our Sons.
Save Our Sons. It has been a wonderful interview. Now, do y'all promise to come back on another time and we can
definitely.
Talk more about this?
Most definitely.
All right. Yes. Thank you once again,
you.
Mr.
Bless.
Jamie Dennis, Director of the Urban League Save Our Sons program, and Mrs. Angelia Bills, the Vice President of Communications for the Urban League St. Louis. Thank you both again.
No, thank you.
All right, friends, we're going to take a short break right here. Stay with me. I'll be right back. Hi, this is Evangelist Nona Thomas, inviting you to tune in to Hallelujah 1600 at 4 p.m. every Wednesday for the midweek message. Friends, let me tell you, this program will encourage you. It will inspire you. It will be the boost that will be right on time in the Word of God for your Wednesday afternoon. So tune in every Wednesday, 4 p.m., right here on Hallelujah 1600 for the midweek message with Evangelist Nona Thomas. To God be the glory.
Greetings, St. Louis. This is Jamie Dennis, Director of the Save Our Sons program from the Urban League of Metropolitan St. Louis. If you want to be a blessing to your father, your brother, or son, or any male that you just care about, please send them our way. You can reach me at 314-388-9840. We're preparing generations for the workforce and jobs, employment, soft skills, financial literacy, leadership development, and career training. For more information, you can look up our program on www.ulstl.com.
The Christian Business Connection is proud to announce that in April, we will be featuring our Author of the Month series, featuring Dr. Gloria Johnson's heartwarming and inspiring book, I Cry Alone. Listen weekly in April as Dr. Johnson talks about this amazing book. Get more info and to get your copy, go to thecbcradioshow.com.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Vance Watt. I'm the worship arts pastor at the Word at Shaw Church here in St. Louis, Missouri, where we serve the community in word and in deed. I'm so excited to be here this morning on the CBC Radio Show with Evangelist Nona Thomas. I'd like to extend a warm welcome to you and your family to come worship with us at the Word at Shaw at 11 a.m. on Sunday morning. We're located at 4265 Shaw Boulevard, St. Louis, Missouri, 63110. Or you can visit our website at www.thewordatshaw.org. God bless.
Hi, this is Michael McMillan, President and CEO of the Urban League of Metropolitan St. Louis. Glad to be here with Evangelist Nona Thomas on the Christian Business Connection radio show.
Morning, saints of God, Reggie Reyes, the Bishop of Comedy on the CBC, and this is your Christian Comedy Network. I need everybody, as I'm on my way to church this morning, I need everybody to touch and agree with me right now, because don't you hate when somebody in front of you and got their blink on and ain't turning? Oh my God, that's what I'm feeling right now. There ain't nobody but the devil. Ain't nobody but the devil that's getting me all upset. Turn off your blinker. So I need, in 3, 2, 1, I need everybody to say, please, the spirit of turn off the blinker come upon this person, and they can turn off their blinker because it's driving me crazy. 3, 2, 1. Look at that. God works. He answered the prayer. The blinker is off. Hallelujah. Oh, wait.
That was my blinker. Oh, I'm sorry. Hey, but God did it. Thank you. Good morning to you. Know you're on your way to church. Whenever you're on your way, make sure you put God first in your life all time. This is Reggie Reyes, the Bishop of Comedy. Love you to life. Peace.
Friends, haven't we had a wonderful program on this Easter Sunday? Oh, I just thank all of my guests. They're just wonderful. You know, God is doing such a great work here in the metropolitan St. Louis area. We just should give him the glory, the honor, and the praise. Yeah, just stop right here and say, Lord, we thank you. I want to thank my pastor, R.B. Peterson, for being on the program. Truly a man of God. I'm just so blessed, and I just thank the Lord for being a part of the ministry, the church at Memorial Tabernacle Christian Life Center. Doing a great work, you are, Pastor Arby. Thank you so much for all that you do. Our First Lady, Sister Kathy Peterson, God bless you. You all are truly servants of the Lord. Now, friends, I want to tell you, if you didn't hear that interview with Reverend Alonzo Griffin and Chef, oh my goodness, Chef Chuck at Old Henry's Restaurant, take my word for it. You just simply want to go over to Old Henry's Restaurant today, Easter Sunday, because they have got a spread that is simply delicious. You know, Old Henry's is located at 8600 Airport Road right there in Berkeley, right off the highway at 170. So they've got some delicious home-style cooking waiting on you. Go on over there today. Old Henry's, they'll be open until 6 o'clock. And then I want to thank, of course, one of my sponsors for the CBC radio show and the Christian Business Connection, the Urban League of Metropolitan St. Louis, Mrs. Angelia Beals and Mr. Jamie Dennis. You know, that interview is so fantastic because it's talking about the Save Our Sons program. They're doing such a great work with that program, not only here in the city of St. Louis, but nationally across the country. So to God be the glory for that. And then, you know what? How can you not laugh and just say, I just love the CBC Christian Comedy Nuggets. Thank you so much, our Bishop of Comedy, Reggie Ridge, for being a part of the CBC radio show for these last 2 months. Hey, we're going to keep it going in April because you know what? Christians need to laugh too. So I thank Reggie Ridge, the Bishop of Comedy, for being a part of the CBC radio show. Friends, there's so much that's going on this program. In the month of April, we're going to be featuring Dr. Gloria Johnson and her fantastic book, I Cried Alone. We're going to spotlight domestic violence in the month of April. And so make sure that you don't miss a Sunday as we're going to be talking with Dr. Johnson and the great things that she has done in her agency and her organization, Life Consultants. So we're going to have a good time in April talking with her. I want to encourage you that if you are a business owner, if you're in ministry, if you have an event coming up or an organization and you would like to promote it, you'd like to talk about it here on the CBC radio show, give me a call, 314-270-2225. That's 314-270-2225. Or simply go to our website, thecbcradioshow.com. So much is going on with the Christian Business Connection. We'll soon be having our upcoming next CBC Evening of Synergy. If you missed the last one, oh, it was a treat. It was a joy. It was great. So we will be announcing that in the month of April, too. So much going on in the Christian Business Connection. I also want to encourage you to go to our website and look under the Spotlight link because that talks about our guests and different events that are coming up in the St. Louis area. If you would like to be featured on our website under our Spotlight page, give us a call at 314-270-2225. And also, friends, in the upcoming weeks, we will be highlighting local gospel artists. We will be featuring local gospel artists and their music. If you have music, Christian music, that you would like aired on the CBC radio show, give me a call. Again, 314-270-2225. 314-270-2225. Again, on this Easter Sunday, thank you for listening to the CBC radio show. And as always, in closing, to God be the glory.
Christian Business Connection.
connecting your business or ministry to the world.